there on your placards. It is there in our minds. And, you know, we can talk about it. There is a certain thing about why science is important to society that many people get. But there is another dimension which I think perhaps in our many decades of working on scientific temper, we have not given such focus, and to which now urgently we must turn our attention. You cannot keep scientific temper in a box that deals only with nature. You cannot talk about scientific temper only in terms of superstition about natural phenomena. You cannot talk about scientific temper only in terms of irrational ideas about how your body works. Because the problem of scientific temper is also affecting the very fabric of our society. The irrationality in social relations, the irrationality of our
go there, we'll go there, we'll go there, go there. There is no place to sit. We'll go there. Everyone sitting.
And scientific approach to the study of all phenomena, whether they are natural or social. If you read Nehru's Discovery of India, he is not talking only about a rational view of the natural world. It is also a rational view of society. And today is Ambedkar Jayanti. Let us remind ourselves that the greatest irrationality of our social life, the most unscientific construction of our social life, is the caste system. There can be no two opinion about it. You cannot be, you know, someone who has a rational view of the world, because there is not an iota of evidence that the hierarchy that caste presumes and caste prescribes has any scientific basis whatsoever. It has a historical basis, it has a social reason, most of it exploited, but it has nothing to do with science. One of the greatest advances that science brought with the development of the biology was the universality of not only human species, but the universality of all living things. And you know, the boundaries between the living and non-living, between primates, between humans, between, you know, other forms of life have inspired others to think of the universality of life. How then in the middle of this can we have the caste system? And the other great irrationality of our society, which we have not eradicated, which is the difference of gender. We all know the background.